All right. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Ms. Optimism Speaks radio show. And we have a lot to talk about right now. When I say a lot to talk about, we have a lot to talk about. So, ladies and gentlemen, unless you were under a rock or something, there's a lot of stuff that happened. With everything that's going on right now, it's really difficult to find out if we're in the 50s, the 40s, the 60s, are we in the 1800s? What is going on? We have protesters coming in that saying that these documents should still be in existence. Then we have some protesters coming in saying they should not be in existence. So we want to know what your thoughts are. You can most definitely go to our webpage, www.misoptimism.com. Talk about what you think. Do you think that these do you think that these statues should be there or not? I mean, people are pissed. I know, I get it. People are through. People are saying that, you know, these statues should stay where they are. They're a piece of history. Then you have some other people saying they're offensive. They're hurtful. These statues and these documents and these flags and these monuments demonstrate nothing but racism, hate, you know, things of that nature. So some people are saying that they belong in a museum instead of belonging in the actual public eye. So we want to know what your thoughts are, what do you think. You could definitely comment on our Facebook page, Ms. Optimism Speaks or Ms. Optimism. And like I said, go ahead and give us a call or comment on our Facebook page or our website page or the Spreaker page. Either way, we are more than happy to hear from you. So shout out to everybody that's listening to the show right now. We are having a great time. Already I'm getting comments with this, and people are saying, no, we should not have those statues at all. These statues are hurtful. These statues should be diminished. They should be demolished, I should say. And not only should they be demolished, they should act like they never existed in the first place. Then we had another one. This one's from Georgia. Georgia said, my grandfather hung on a tree next to one of those Confederate flags and that Robert Lee statue. So how dare they say that there's no significant ties to anyone's hurt or pain. You know, I hear you, Georgia. I mean, I remember hearing stories about even my grandmother saying how, you know, they were in the cotton fields when she was a little girl, and when they were no longer sanctioned, for lack of a better word, to be in the field, she said a lot of people didn't know what to do. You know, a lot of people were in that mentality like, well, slavery is the best thing that happened to us because we don't know anything else outside of that. You know, we would take it from a country, a land, and, you know, we were used to one thing, and now it's something else. So we definitely have a lot to say about that. Also, we're going to talk about Takiyah Thompson. Yes, homegirl that climbed up on that monument, tied the rope, and they pulled that puppy down. Mm-hmm. Takiyah Thompson was taken in for charges. They said that she is in for defacing property, and we'll have more of that story in as well. Also, David Duke giving Trump a high five and a hands up. Really, Sessions wants to give subpoenas out for those that participated in the quote-unquote alt-left, and they said that they need to be held responsible for that. So what is the real reason for the flip-flop? At first, David Sessions was condemning what took place. Now, all of a sudden, he wants to put subpoenas and sanctions for those who participated. So we want to know, you know, do you think David Duke is behind that? Do you think that they got some kind of backlash for supporting it? We want to know. And then lastly, the Business Council, the one that has been around since 1933, okay? That's how significant and important it is. Since 1933, the Business Council has been in existence and has been side by side with top leaders of the executive branch of the government. Now, 45 wants to get rid of the Business Council because CEOs are leaving in droves because of what happened with his late response as it relates to what took place in Charlottesville, Virginia. So, again, we want to know what you think. Tell us, you know, do you think that she should have been arrested? We're talking about Takiyah Thompson. Do you think that Heather, the young lady that was unfortunately massacred and killed during that Charlottesville debacle, Heather Heyer, you know, there's, I think it was called the Daily Storm. The Daily Storm was actually removed from any domain. They are going to have to change their whole getup. But they were removed because they were told what they were talking about was hate. They were labeling Heather as a fat slob, as a childless BI, you know what else. And they basically said that she that was better for her to no longer be in existence. So, I mean, I think that was a little rude, a little rough, a little mean, a little disrespectful to talk about the deceased the way that they did. But, you know, that's crazy. We also have some really other cute news. Bonnie Tyler is going to sing Total Eclipse of the Heart during the eclipse. Do you have your glasses? Are you ready? What is going on? So, again, if you want to go ahead and call in, you could go ahead and do so by dialing 619-639-4644. All calls will be screened because of the nature of this call, I mean, of this show. Or if you just want to comment, you can go ahead and do that too. Time now is 10:08. 10:08, you're listening to the Ms. Optimism Speaks radio show, and we are broadcasting, talking about what is going on. So trending right now in Durham, North Carolina, Takiya Thompson is hailed as a hero. She is showered with support for toppling the Confederate statue. People are loving her. They said that she's facing felony charges in the wake of the Durham, North Carolina protest. And they're saying that she should not have done that. However, at the press conference, she was receiving standing ovations and was saying that she is a hero, a hero, a hero, a hero. So let's find out what they're saying. They said that she is being arrested for vandalism. Okay, so a statement from Sheriff Mike Andrews says, I am grateful the events that unfolded Monday evening did not result in serious injury or in the loss of life. But the planned demonstration should serve as a sobering example of the price we all pay when civil disobedience, I'm ready for this, is no longer civil. Before the protest, my staff met with our community partners to discuss how to safely and appropriately respond to the protest. County leaders were aware of the risk of damage of the Confederate statue, as well as potential risk of injury to the public and officers should deputies attempt to control the crowd. Collectively, we decided that restraint and public safety would be our priority. And as a sheriff, I am not blind to the offensive conduct of some demonstrators, nor will I ignore their criminal conduct. With help of video that captured the scene, my investigators are working to identify those responsible for the removal and vandalism of the statue. My deputies show great restraint and respect for the constitutional rights of the group expressing their anger, as well as disgust for the recent events in our country. Racism and incivility have no place in our country or in Durham, and I am asking both city and county leaders to establish guidelines and safe spaces for protesters to prevent demonstrations from becoming disruptive and, as we witnessed in Charlottesville, dangerous. Rightfully, and they just go on and on and on how they were talking about the safety of the statue. However, because of the videos, they were able to find who was the exact person that took down the statue. So Takiya Thompson, a 22-year-old student activist who participated in tearing the statue down, okay, she said enough was enough. She was, she's been released from jail, and Thompson is now one of four people as of Wednesday afternoon who have been arrested for damaging the monument and a move that people are saying is just unjust. On Monday, Thompson and several other demonstrators removed the Confederate soldiers' monument. And in doing so, they did that in front of the local government offices in Durham. Now, people were saying it was a public protest, and other people were saying it was outright vandalism. How dare she get rid of that statue? It wasn't bothering her. She had no business doing that. And unfortunately, this was a response to the Unite the Right rally that was held by white supremacists in Charlottesville, Virginia, over the weekend. So Thompson is a student at Historically Black College in North Carolina, which is North Carolina Central. I wish they didn't put her information out there because people who are really upset with her are really going to be after her, for a lack of better words. So people would say, breaking, Takiya Thompson, who climbed to the Confederate statue in Durham, is in solidarity, was arrested, drop the charges. So a lot of people are saying, drop the charges, drop the charges. Don't even charge this woman for what she did because, again, that statue is offensive, and it appeared as if no one was going to do anything about it. So that's why Takiya did what she did. So do you think that she was right? Do you think that she had a point in what she was doing? Do you think that she went about it the wrong way? Do you think that she should have been arrested or not be arrested? You let me know by going to the page, again, www.midoptimism.com, or you can go to my page and let people know what's going on and why it's important to talk about what's going on in our nation. I mean, right about now, the racial tension is thick. I'm talking like seriously thick like a ribeye, you know, that kind of thing. And the problem with that is, you know, you don't want people to get to a point where now they feel that their voices are not heard. You don't get to a point where people are feeling that their voices are not valued. You also don't want to get to a point where people are feeling like, why should we even bother? Because leadership isn't even helping us out. And that's a segue to the next topic. There's just so much that's going on with this, and there's so many things that's wrong with this whole entire situation. I mean, we shouldn't have to wait until an elected official says something about this. It's wrong, and we know it's wrong, and because it's wrong, we need to just say something about it. Call a spade a spade. You know, look, it was wrong. I know people are angry, you know, and President Obama said it most. I didn't create the racism. You created the racism with your intolerism of me being a president. You know, back in the day, you have to remember, we weren't even allowed to have a job, let alone run, you know, be in office as the highest elected official in the entire world, you know? So there are a lot of people who are extremely angry about this, and because they're angry, they're trying to show just how pissed off they are by talking about what's going on and also making sure that people, how can I say it, that people are no longer going to, you know, demonstrate the way that they did. So, again, if you want to go ahead and talk about what you would talk about, please, you know, you could go ahead and do so. Or, again, you go to my website and talk about it. It is 10:15 Eastern Standard Time. You are listening to Ms. Optimism Speech Radio. We're going to go for a quick commercial break. And, yeah, we'll be right back. All right, so we have one break on one show, and I'm actually broadcasting more than one show. So that's the reason why I was a little bit of a little delay. So we're going to keep talking about this. I cannot wait to hear some of your thoughts and some of your opinions as it relates to, you know, as it relates to the actual events that took place this weekend. Don't be shy to give me your thoughts or opinions. And again, these are your thoughts and opinions, and they're valued just like anybody else's. If you thought that they were wrong, say they were wrong. If you thought they were right, let us know what you think. But by all means, please make sure that you continue to talk about your rights. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so we are back. You are on the Ms. Optimism Speaks Radio Show, and we are live not only on two stations, but on Facebook. So if you want to comment about something, let us know, and we will definitely honor your comment. Or if you want to call, please go ahead and do so. We are more than welcome to listen to your comments. And also, if you want to speak and talk about what's going on, go ahead and do that as well. The phone number again is area code 619-639-4644. Again, 619-639-4644. Or you could text the show 364-088-0886. Again, that is 302-364-0886. And we will definitely share your comment on air, but you have to let us know what you want to say. Any lewd or rude or disrespectful comments will definitely not be read. So, again, we are on live right now. I am so excited about what's going on. Unfortunately, some other people are not excited with what's going on because of all the turmoil. I have never seen anything like this. Like, this is getting to the point now where, you know, people are afraid to talk. People are afraid to do anything because they're saying, like, wow, you know, we can't have our opinion because if we have our opinion, we're going to be viewed as this. You have some people that don't want to talk about anything because they feel if they say something, then people are going to say, well, if you believe in this, then we can't support you. And that's not how America was meant to be. That's not how we were, you know, founded. I mean, even though we were founded on some really jacked up stuff, at the end of the day, it ended up being something totally different. So I want to hear your opinion on the following story. What do you think about, I'll say number 45, for lack of a better word. What do you think about number 45 all of a sudden backtracking on his statement? So on Saturday, you know, when the situation happened, you know, he had this really bland response about what took place in Charlottesville. It was very generic. It was very, as a matter of fact-ish. It was very, I don't want anything to do with this, but I have no choice but to say something because. And people were really upset about it. So then, all of a sudden, he came out with this fiery, you know, oh, everybody is wrong, the Klan, this person, that person, and we shouldn't tolerate this type of racism, you know, so on and so forth.